Hello, I'm Anjuli, and in this video I will show you how you can configure your .NET Core WebAPI to connect with Microsoft Entra ID. Okay, so let's get started by creating a .NET Core WebAPI project. As you can see, I already created one before, so I will just click here and just call it Webshop API. Click Next. And important here, you can choose an authentication type. And if you choose the Microsoft Identity platform, it will actually already configure almost everything for you, which is great. So just pick that one and click Create. And this will take you to this page. It might also prompt you to install some components for the first time, but I already did that. So it will now show me this page. And I've chosen my test tenant, which is my customer tenant. You can also see Microsoft Entra External ID behind it. This is different than a workforce tenant, which is an organization's default Entra tenant. As you can see, I don't have any application registered here, so I'll just click Create New. And I will call it Webshop API. And this will automatically create the registration in Microsoft Entra ID. And this is a unique identifier that is generated for this application. So when this application is published to an app service and it talks to Entra ID, then it also delivers this application ID so that Entra ID knows that it's this application we're talking about. You can click Finish. The first thing we'll look at is the program, because it added this line, and this is the configuration for the authentication in your API. And it gets the configuration properties from your appsettings.json underneath the Azure AD name. But I think this will be changed to Entra ID, at least I hope so, because Azure AD is Azure Active Directory, and that's the old Entra ID name. I guess they forgot to change it. So when we go to the appsettings.json, you can see here all the things that it has generated for us. The authority is the endpoint where your application will go to connect with Entra ID. The client ID is then again the unique identifier for your application. And also another important thing is the scopes. And these are actually the permissions that a front-end application or a user needs to have to be able to access this API. And you can also see this in the controllers, because if you go to the weather forecast controller, here you have the required scope. And this means that for every method within this application, you need the scopes that are defined in the appsettings.json. You can also add this underneath a method, and then you can have multiple scopes. For instance, you can have read scopes, and then you can configure it for each method separately. This can be convenient when you want to have read permissions and write permissions separately, for when you have like an application that can only read data from the database and applications that can only write data from the database. And you can configure this in your app settings. And then instead of doing this, you add an object called read. And you call this weather read. This doesn't automatically create permissions, because you have to create the permissions or scopes in Microsoft Entra ID Admin Center. For now, I'll just keep it as it was to make it easy. And also change this back. When you go to Microsoft Entra ID to entra.microsoft.com, then you go to your tenant where you registered your application. And for me, it was the test tenant, which is a customer tenant, like I said. And if you go to the left to applications and then app registrations, your API will be registered here with the client ID or application ID. It's the same thing that was already in the app settings.json. So if you click on the Webshop API, and go to expose an API, here is where the scopes are defined. And as you can see, I will make this a bit bigger. Here's the access as user scope. So the first part is for in this URL is your tenant address, and then your application identifier, and then the scope name. If you want to add a scope, you can click here. You can give it a proper name. You have to configure who can consent. So this is something that you have to think about. It's like an extra security measure, actually. So now I'm the only one in my company, so I'm also the admin. But if you're a developer in a company and you are not the admin of this environment, then you as admin, or someone as an admin, has to grant access to this API. So if you configure scopes here, you for instance want an application, a front-end application, to be able to read the data from your API, I can do weather dot read or underscore read, and if I add this scope before it can actually be assigned to a front-end application, an admin has to say, okay, this can be assigned to this front-end application. In that way, it's an extra security measure. And here is, well, like it says, admin consent display name, admin consent description. This is just for the admin to see what kind of scope this is and why he should or should not consent with it. I won't edit for now. I will just keep access as user to make it easy. In the background, I have published my app, so we can reach it from my front-end application. So you can see here my .NET MAUI app, and if I click Get Data, it will show 401 forbidden, because I haven't logged in yet. So when I click Login and enter my credentials, and I click Get Data again, it will show me a little bit ugly, but it will show me what I get back from the API. So I've authenticated and now I can access the API. So now you know how you can register your .NET Web API in Entra ID and how you can configure it to actually talk to it. And also how you can add permissions to your front-end application that's already registered in Entra ID. In my next video, I will show you how to configure a .NET MAUI application for Windows, iOS, macOS, and Android, so that it can also talk with Entra ID, and show you how to configure that in Entra ID as well. I hope you liked this video. Please leave a comment below if you did, and I'll hope to see you next time. Bye!